here I am. Started my 48-hour odyssey. Got everything all set up here in the Durango. As you can see, got all the goodies set out. Everything's organized, extra clothes, place to crash, all kinds of food. And if you look outside here, got a nice little area set up under the rain, little tarp, cooler, whatnot. So I think I'm pretty much ready to go. It's not cold outside, but it is wet, so I think I'll probably start off with a shell on top of my what I'm wearing right now. I'm pretty much ready to go. I'm not going to carry any water the first lap, but every 4K there's an aid station. Anyway, looking forward to it. 48 hours, here I come.
Are you kidding? I can run like 10 minutes. I wish I froze. I would do better in the heat.
Ron, how are you?
Good, how are you doing, Ron?
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Okay. How
could I be a girl? Okay,
someone call Fred.
Red. She offered to get one for the team tonight. So you got to ready to go back to 4 hours. I don't think she knows what she's getting into.
Ron, can you do me a favor? Can you call Fred? Welcome everybody to the inaugural 48 hours. Woo! Thank someone or kill someone after it, Charlotte and Kinga. For the ones who initiated this. Okay, so I think I've said this several times, so just to reiterate, because I always consider myself a Yahoo, but when it comes to race planning, I notice I'm extremely conservative. And I'm like right on my insurance people, making sure things are covered. So that's why we have the check-in, but also I am very concerned. You know, it's kind of interesting. I think we've all been there and seen people. Like, I don't know if anybody saw Jody Langley at Premore when she was deathly ill. There was a guy here in the 32K who had to be taken away to emergency. He was deathly ill. So hopefully that won't happen to anybody here. So the weigh-in should be outside on the portable. Again, we'll pull you off course when we see you coming through, 7 to 9 a.m. tomorrow morning, Saturday, and again in the evening. If it's just you, you have no pacer and crew, we'll be dealing with just you. But make sure we only deal, if you have a pacer or crew, we're dealing with one other person, no excess people. When you officially finish, please check in with me so I can mark you off. I got an idea for my race plan. You really not watching
it. Off already?
Why do I want to run with a wet shirt?
He's leaving his pants on, so it's all good.
Yeah, for the first half of the race, yes.
Yes, it is.
Wait,
second half.
I don't know if I want to line up towards the front.
I need to stand beside my tour guide.
And we should stand at the back.
Oh.
This is nice.
Okay. Day one.
Day one.
Yeah, we'll just take a picture every time. Yeah. Just see how you guys are progressing.
Yeah. Maybe not that last lap.
It was safe.
We have
guess we're about 6 hours, 20 minutes in, and just finished off my fifth lap, so that's 40K. First loop, man, we got rain like crazy. Remind me of Creemore, the streams or the pathways turned into streams, and there was a lot of wet, but it really felt good. No heat at all, felt great getting through the first loop. Second loop, sort of the same, a lot of rain. Let up in the third loop, good music, and third and fourth loop, and this loop was a nice quiet loop. Feeling pretty good. I've been eating. Had an egg, been drinking water, had a Coke, eating potato salad, macaroni salad, also lots of water, and not feeling too bad, although feeling like maybe I might need a bit more in the way of calories. So I started gelling on this last loop there, at the last aid station, at about 38K, had my first gel of the day. Anyway, I'm going to have a peanut butter and jam sandwich, probably have a little orange juice with it, maybe some water, and head back out. Not feeling too bad, a little bit of pain in the legs, things are starting to hurt a little bit, but not too bad. Anyway, Still raining. Impressive will be. It's just a little bit after 4 o'clock and it is raining like crazy. I was gonna head back out, but I figured I'd just let it wait a little while till the rain lets up. Just look at it coming off the windshield. It's just nuts. This is my tarp. The rain coming off the tarp. Anyway, I'm through 48K now, and I'd like to get going again, but like I said, I just wait a few minutes till the rain lets up a bit. All right, it's just a little after 10 o'clock. Just gone through my 10th lap, so that's 14 hours since I started this morning, and 80K, which is halfway to my minimum objective. I've got 48 hours to do it, and I've reached the halfway point in 14 hours, so I'm pretty happy about that. So definitely looking good to finish the 100 miles in reasonable time. Right now I'm feeling pretty good, although I've lost my appetite and I need to eat some more. My feet are just in an unbelievably excruciatingly painful, so it's not a pretty thing. I'm going to keep going at least until daylight before I do anything with my feet. I want to get to 15 or 16 laps before I maybe change my shoes and have a look at my feet. I'm hoping to go through, I got about 8 hours to daybreak. If I can get another 5 laps in before then, I'd be really thrilled. I'm still moving pretty good, but gotta keep eating. Feeling a little nauseous, not a lot, but you know, the day's starting to catch up with me. I mean, I just ran almost 2 marathons and some pretty challenging conditions. One thing that's kind of bugging me right now is it's really, really kind of sticky, warm, and I'm sweating a fair bit too. Although I'm definitely not dehydrated, I'm just drinking tons, and I've never been as well hydrated in a race as I am right now. So if I keep that up, that's going to really, really help. But these breaks are nice, although it's getting harder and harder and harder to get going again. But I do, you know. Anyway, I'll check in again in another 5 laps around when I'm sitting at around 120K. And it'll probably be daylight by then, I would imagine, but probably fairly early. We'll see. We'll see how it
goes. Right. Well, 13 laps down, and it's time for a major dilemma. My feet are just unbelievably painful, so I have to do something about it. I'm going to take my shoes, socks, wet shoes off. I've got a pair of decent shoes that are dry and dry socks. I'm going to pop the blisters, put some band-aids on it, and hope and pray that they feel a little bit better. Anyway, I'm just taking them off here now. Right foot. Oh, God. Oh, it hurts. Oh. They don't look as bad as they feel, that's for sure. Toes are kind of messed up, though. Ouch, 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 ouch. Other foot. Ow. Ow, ow, they stick. Man. Oh, that one's nasty. That's what was really just hurting just a few minutes ago. It's really a big blister right on the heel. Not to mention the rest of the foot is a mess. Look at that little toe. That one is just nasty. Ow, ow, ow. Anyway, I got some work to do. Check this one out. The big toe. It is really, really, really nasty. Right there. Ow, 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 ow. That is huge. Huge. You know, I've had some blisters before. I've had some pretty bad ones. But I have never seen my feet that bad, so it kind of explains just why I was in such phenomenal pain. I mean, it is incredible. Now, I've popped most of them. I'll go through and do it again in a few minutes. I gotta let them dry out, then I'm gonna put some bandage on it, but it's gonna be a while. I'm probably done for a little while. I've got 13 laps in, 7 laps to go. That's a little more than what I wanted at this point, but I really don't have any choice. It's certainly quite doable to get to the 100 miles. I was hoping to be able to finish off the 100 miles by lunchtime shortly thereafter, but it's probably going to be in the evening or maybe towards dark, but we'll see how it goes. I got to get these feet taken care of before I do anything
else. Well, it's 12:40 and I've just completed my 15th lap, or 120 kilometers. Fully expected to be here more than four and a half, five hours ago, but at 3:30 I stopped with my foot problem and I didn't get going again until 9:30. I didn't get going again until 9:30 because I had my feet taped and bandaged up, and it still hurts, but I'm doing a lot better than I was. Anyway, I only got 5 laps to meet my minimum goal. Hopefully by dinner time tonight I'll either have 1 or 2 laps to go. Won't be too bad. Might have to do 1 lap in the dark tonight, but that's okay. That won't be a problem. But making progress. Got all kinds of time. I could have a snooze and go back out, or I could just chill out here for a while and go back out and have finished the race, but I really do want to get another 2 or 3 laps behind me and get down to the last 2. Anyway, it's getting sunny and it's kind of humid, so heat's going to be a factor now too as well.
Well, I'm done. The feet became quite painful again after some more rain, but I'm finished 100 miles and I'm very happy about it. I was able to run pretty much the whole way. It was awesome, and now I'm done.